you awake?
What's wrong, little one?
I cannot sleep. Would you tell me the story again?
Oh, come here, little rabbit. Should I bring some biscuits as well? Once upon a time, in a normal cabin near the forest. There lived a wise woman, known far and wide for her gentle spirit. Mrs. Warmwood loved nature and the secrets it whispered through the rustling of leaves and the melodies of the rain. But, above all, she loved being at home, a place that, more often than not, was a shelter for forest travelers and villages on stormy days. The wind whistled through the trees, and the raindrops hit the windows with all their strength. But inside her cabin, a crackling fireplace and the aroma of freshly baked bread would make her visitors forget the fierce thunderstorm. Anyone could find in her cozy cabin a reason to be grateful. Her place was adorned with wooden accents, snug blankets, baskets crammed with herbs and produce, and jars filled with chocolate and biscuits. She spent most of her time carving the most beautiful shapes and utensils from the branches of ancient trees. She would say that the trees taught her about patience and all the lessons hidden in the cycles of nature. The people of the village adore her. On stormy days, they would knock at her cabin door, drawn in by the inviting glow peeping out her windows. They would cluster around the hearth, listening to the crackling fire and the distant thunders. As the storm raged outside, she would light candles, bring them sweet snacks, and sit among them to teach them what she used to call the art of the storm. She encouraged the villagers to close their eyes and listen closely, not just with their ears, but with their bodies and souls. She reminded them that even in the fiercest tempest, an undeniable serenity was always waiting to be heard. Even when the rain continued to pour against the roof and the windows, they would close their eyes and cradle the warm calves between their fingers. Thunder would transform into rhythmic drums, and rain would become a soothing choir. Not a single child or adult was ever scared of thunder or lightning, and no one seemed to feel down because of the summer atmosphere. Instead, on the gloomiest days, they found a reason to discover the secrets of nature and an opportunity to indulge in the cosiest of pleasures. The art of the storm became a cherished legacy passed down through generations, ensuring that the hidden melodies of the storm still echoed in the villagers' hearts for years to come.
Thank you. Thank you.